Hello and a very warm welcome to all of you to my channel. So as you can see, this is the English version of the video on the cruise update. So the cruise is ready, it is painted well, but there are some works pending, so we'll talk about those. First of all, the major thing which is pending is to put a spoiler in the back. So that needs to be painted. It is at the workshop. We also need to put the diffuser in the back. There are some interior related customization which we have to do. First of all, we have to clean the interior properly. So this needs to be steam cleaned. All these areas that you can see are pretty dirty, like, you know, there is hand marks and other stuff. So this needs to be cleaned properly, so I'm going to give it for a proper interior cleaning soon. Apart from that, there is some customization that I have planned, like in certain areas where you see these black, like this area, the area above, and you know, the surrounding around the stereo. I'm thinking of wrapping it in 5D carbon fiber. I have already wrapped two pieces in 5D carbon fiber, so I'm going to wrap the rest as well. So for that I have to remove this panel and do it, so I'm going to plan doing that maybe little later, not at the moment. So that is the plan about the interior. So we had some serious challenges with the car, and this car was given for repairs in the month of August, and this is March, so you know, almost 6-7 months is where the car was missing out of action. So we are going to talk about the kind of work that was done, and also, you know, the kind of support that you get once you have a great mechanic with you. So I have a similar mechanic who supports me with everything. So as you can see in the engine bay, there is a beauty cover that comes on top, which is not installed yet. The main reason why it was not installed is we wanted to check if there is any sort of leak, or you know, any sort of let's say coolant related issues. So this vehicle originally went to the workshop with heating issue. So there are two fans, one of the fan was not working properly, so it was either running in full speed or not running at all. So we started with that. We actually fixed the fan, so that fan started working well. Then also we had this overheating issue. The overheating issue was mainly that the coolant was boiling in the coolant reservoir, and it would boil out eventually. So because of that, the car will start overheating, plus if we pour any amount of coolant, it will be lost. And you know, by the time the car starts overheating, there is absolutely no coolant in the car. So there are two regulators, one for each fan. One of the regulator had little problem, plus also since the time I bought this car, I always had a problem with the AC condenser fan not running. So what we did is, we, instead of repairing the old fan, that was one mistake that we made, we actually replaced the fan with a Verna fan, and it was retrofitted. The problem with Verna is that the fins are in the opposite direction, so because of which everything had to be changed. And you know, like I said, the coolant was always boiling with the Verna fan as well. So the next thing that we could logically do is to check the radiator for blocks. So you know, the radiator is actually new. I replaced it last year because there was a slight crack in the old radiator, and since the oil cooler and the radiator comes a single unit, they were not ready to repair it. The crack was in the plastic part. It could have been repaired with JB Weld, but the, you know, company was not very you know, confident in doing that. So both these hose pipes were not getting warm, so that's how we diagnosed that the radiator is blocked. So you know, I'll put a small video showing you the blockade in the radiator. So first, thing that was diagnosed was there was no flow coming into the coolant reservoir. So that is the out from the water pump. So that was the first thing to inspect. We removed the water pump and we found that it was badly corroded. So we replaced the water pump and the flow towards the reservoir was resumed, but at the same time these two pipes which you see were not getting hot equally. So for further investigation we took apart the radiator and this is exactly what we found in that. So you can see the amount of dirt that is there in the radiator. So all of that is basically kind of a muddy deposit. So this thing actually holds a very important clue to our problem. So at that time we just cleaned the radiator thoroughly, remove all this muddy deposit, and then we went on our way back and we started thinking that the issue is resolved, because the coolant, both the pipes were equally getting warm now, and the fans were kicking in on time. So the mechanic that I have is a very smart and intelligent mechanic. The reason why I say that is he is a very multi-talented guy. So this guy, is a mechanic, he is an electrician, he fixes electronics, like he repairs ECM and all. He's a painter, he is a denting guy. So it's really impossible to get a combination like that from one person, because what happens is there are certain ideas which only comes to, let's say, a painter, that doesn't come to a mechanic. So those things, when a person is multi-talented, he can actually use some idea which is used for painting for doing some mechanical work. So I'll come to that. That is a very interesting topic. So we got the car painted. There was just couple of panels that we decided to paint. We wanted to just paint the front bumper, we wanted to paint the two fenders and also the bonnet. So when we were planning to do this kind of paint, the main reason is the bumper that you see is not a normal cruise bumper. This is a bumper specifically made by a modifying group in Delhi called Auto Psyche. So during my days in Delhi, I had met Arush, who is Auto Psyche's owner, through a couple of Team BHP meets, and he is a very friendly guy. So this bumper was there in only one another cruise in Kerala, that was also from Trivandrum, and that car got sold somewhere in the north of Kerala, and the whereabouts of that car are not known anymore. Also, I have seen couple of other cars with this bumper. Auto Psyche, I think, has done two more cars with this kind of a bumper, and there was a group in Chennai which had copied this. So this bumper is made of fiberglass, so there were some rivet marks where I just pointed, and it was not looking good. So we decided that we will paint the bumper and also the fenders, because since the bumper is very low, every time it used to hit it, the road, it used to crackle the fender just above the tire line, exactly somewhere around the point where the tire actually meets the fender, somewhere around this area. So it used to crack there. So what I had to do is I had to get these three painted. But then once we upgraded to 17 inch alloys, the scraping has reduced to a great extent. So anyways, the car was due for painting. So we thought of painting these three parts, but we ended up painting the whole car. The reason being, the previous guy, this car originally was in golden color. So I painted this. So these lines, these grooves that you see were not defined by the previous painter. He actually had a lot of putty applied on all of this, and because of this it was not visible. Also the kind of primer that he used was pretty bad, so all the sanding marks were visible outside. So that was another biggest problem. So this car used to look great from around 10 to 15 feet away, but as soon as you come closer you will see all those imperfections, and it was an eyesore. I definitely hated the way the car looked, and to me it is very important that the vehicles that I drive match the level of perfection that I like to see. So there are some places that needs to be buffed and all, but we will do that later. So this tail light, as you can see, was broken while the mechanic was trying to take the car for the overheating fix. So what he did is he reversed the car, and if you can see, that wall has two different ledges. So he looked at the yellow part and he reversed, and then he saw the gray part which is below. So the tail light was cracked, but I just want to show you the amazing work this guy has done. So if you look from a distance, you can't see that the tail light has been repaired, and you won't believe it was cracked. The parts, the pieces went missing. We could not collect all the pieces, and what he did is he cut this out of another tail light. He fixed it on this, and then he clear coated the entire tail light, so it now looks as if nothing happened to it, unless and until somebody knows that this tail light is cracked and he comes closer, 3-4 inch closer, and he looks at this tail light. That is when he might notice that there is something different, but otherwise you can't see anything. See this area, there were huge cracks, but nothing is visible now. He has done a phenomenal job in fixing it, though he has asked me, he has told me that he will pay the bill for replacing this tail light. Unfortunately, since crews, most of the cruises, the sales have reduced, so people, what they do is they don't buy these tail lights, so there are very less number of people who have these tail lights in stock. So there was one guy in Trivandrum who had this. He was asking for 20,000 rupees for the entire set. They won't sell it individually, so that was another problem that we had. Then what we did is we actually, after painting the car, I took the delivery of the car. I kind of stood on top of my mechanic's head, and on one night somewhere around 11:30-12, I got the car delivered. So it was fun, I was driving the car home. My wife really loves the car because of these beadings. She used to see the old Baleno, she used to ask me if we can take this beading and fit it in our car. But the Cruze already comes with this beading. The beading above is something that I stuck later on. So this is one car that she really enjoys. Secondly, it has a great music system in it, so she loves listening to music in this car. So next day, while I was taking her to the office, the temperature started climbing again. So the problem with us petrol heads is if something like this happens, we kind of lose our mind, we go bonkers, and it becomes really difficult for us to concentrate on anything else. So the first thing that I did is I took the car to the workshop again, and then he looked at everything. At that time, initially he saw the fan was not running as he fixed in the past. It was running slow, so he fixed the fan again, but then that didn't solve the issue. So this guy knew that I have already spent a huge amount of money, so he wanted this not to become a open money pit. So what he did is, without letting me know or without informing me, he took the head and removed it just to see what is going on. So when he removed the head, we were in for a major shock. The moment the head was off, we noticed that the entire head is kind of corroded badly. This is an aluminium head, so it has corroded badly. All the water passages are corroded, and they are actually taking combustion from the cylinder and passing it on to the coolant reservoir, so that is why it was boiling. There was a constant air leak coming from there. But then we definitely found the problem, but the solution was not cheap. The original head for Cruze without any fittings in it is around 1.25 lakhs from the showroom. So that is definitely not something that we wanted to do on this car, because you know, let's be very honest. If I try to sell this car, I might not be able to get a lot of money, so it doesn't make sense to actually replace the head with a brand new head. And secondly, my aim is to keep this car for a maximum of 5 more years, because first of all, I don't want to spend my money in a brand new car. Right now, I would like to save it and do certain things which are higher up in the priority. So this definitely doesn't you know, come in the priority list. So we started looking for used you know, cylinder head. So my mechanic started his sources, I started searching my sources. So he spoke to a couple of people. There were, you know, Chevrolet Cruze heads available in Chennai, so you know, the price were around 18 to 20k there. So I also found some people. I spoke to a guy in Surat. So what I've done is, in the past, I've taken some stuff, like, you know, a door handle from him. So, you know, I had this active relationship, so I thought maybe, you know, this guy will give it to me little cheaper, but he wanted 20k for it again. So we decided not to pursue the head anymore. And you know, it was all very crazy situation for us. Then my mechanic actually speaks to some people in the you know, Cruze workshop in the service center, and he finds out that the Optra head is exactly same as the Cruze head, the Optra diesel head. So there is no difference in the head or the internals that come in the head, including the camshaft. The only difference comes in the size of the injectors, the turbo and the block. So those were different from this. So what we did is, we actually started calling some more people. The moment, you know, we started inquiring about Optra parts, the prices started coming down. So there was this amazing place that, you know, I would someday take you guys with me. It is a junkyard in a place in Kerala called Adur, which is almost like roughly around 80-85 kilometers one way from where I am. So we decided that we will go there and we will get the Optra head from the junkyard. So my mechanic called the owner of the junkyard just to make sure that there is enough number of heads there, so that we can choose rather than, you know, take whatever is available. So we called him. He said he has about 4 engines lying, and he told us that we can take a head from whichever engine we want, so which was very reassuring. So you know, the very next day I and my mechanic went to Adur. But you know, I want to mention one thing very specifically. You know, people do not understand that the time of these mechanics are very valuable. Like, you know, especially my mechanic, who's a multi-talented guy, his time is very valuable, because there are people from all over the country who call him, like, you know, they have issue with ECM, they have issue with ABS or any complicated stuff. And this guy is so experienced that he can tell on the phone itself that you need to do this, and they, when they do it, this issue is fixed. So you know, over the phone itself, every phone call he makes close to 500-600 bucks. He doesn't demand that money, because you know, he is trying to help another workshop guy, but those guys, out of professional courtesy, transfer the money to this guy's account. So in a day, if my mechanic is at his workshop, he easily makes 30-35,000 rupees. But he decided to forfeit that, you know, money that he makes, and he decided to come with me to this place to, you know, buy me a you know, Optra head, which will save me a lot of money. So we went to this place. This is an amazing place. You know, this place is spread out in at least 20-25 acres, and you won't believe, there is a checkpost that leads to that area, and the people of the junkyard decide whether you should come out of there or not. Like, you know, you can definitely not go there, create a scene and, you know, try to steal something and come out, because these guys literally decide if you should be, you know, let out or not. So once we go inside, there are, you know, parts everywhere. Sensors are lying on the ground. You know, there is absolutely no value for them. So if you request them, they can also give it to you for free if you are taking some other part, of course. So with the head, we got the complete head with the fingers, valves, you know, stem seals, everything installed. The cam was also installed. We also got the head gasket. And, you know, apart from that, we also got the valve cover packing, everything. We took some, you know, miscellaneous tubes, etc. So everything was, you know, you won't believe if I say it was just 8,000 rupees. So we took it back, then, you know, everything was kind of, we got it back. But, you know, this is where I am going to tell you how a multi-talented mechanic comes into, you know, being. So what happened is, our mechanic is so multi-talented that he knew that, you know, there will be slight warpage in any head that you buy. So this head that we bought also had a bit of warpage, and he used a sanding machine that is used to sand the body of a car to actually face it, instead of giving it to the lathe. Because if you give it to the lathe, you have to remove all the valves, all the stem seals, everything. So this guy manually turned each valve and, you know, grinded it, and then he applied a guide coat of paint on that, and again he looked if everything is level. So, you know, hardly he might have taken a 0.25 of an inch out of the head. Usually if you give it to a lathe, they take out around 1 to 2 mm. There are some, you know, marks that form over a head over a period of time, like, you know, there is this diesel injection spray which happens continuously. So there are the spray marks on the head, then the piston hits the top dead center, so there is a mark there. So all those things were perfectly done. The car is perfect. So I'm, you know, really happy with what has happened. So apart from that, there are some other updates that I wanted to give you quickly. The Shaolin is back for a small engine leak, oil leak. We fixed it. It's going to go. The Zen is the next guy in the line to get a complete makeover. So since the Cruise is back, now I can work on the Zen. But before I do anything on the Zen, I want my wife to learn driving on it, so that, you know, she could cause some damage on it, and then we can really change the entire shell, all the panels, and do it properly this time. So yeah, that's the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like, share and subscribe, and we'll catch you in the next video. Thank you.